नमस्ते जी, नमस्ते। सो होप यू आर कीपिंग वेल एंड डूइंग ग्रेट। वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट टू ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन क्वेश्चंस दैट पीपल मेक अ ग्रेव एरर इन देयर इंटरव्यूज। सो व्हेन यू एवर स्टार्ट एन इंटरव्यू, इट इज ऑलवेज स्टार्टिंग विद मोस्टली टेल अस समथिंग अबाउट योर सेल्फ और टेल अस अबाउट योर स्ट्रेंथ एंड वीकनेसेस। दैट इज वेरी मच द सेकेंड आंसररी क्वेश्चन दैट फॉलोज दिस वन। एंड पीपल यूजली स्टार्ट टू हैव एन ऑर्गेजम हियर। व्हाट डू आई मीन बाय दैट? स्टॉप इट। We need to have predefined answers to these questions so that we can answer and come across confidently. That is the main point of an interview. The other person already has a list of your achievements, your work experience, your list of degrees, where you're coming from, where you're going. They know everything from your CV. I mean, that is the point of the CV, right? When they're asking you this, tell us something about yourself, right? So they already know your name, they already know your pitaji ka name, your mataji ka name, your degrees, right? They are not asking you to elaborate, basically. Again, repeat the same point rather, not elaborate. Just repeat the same point over and over. We'll need to find out the intention of the mens rea, basically, legally speaking, of the interviewer to ask you this certain question. Now, if you want more videos such as that, we are having a fabulous discussion on career choices and the type of intelligence, basically the type of person you are and what suits you best, on our personal channel. The link is in the iCard, the comments, the description below. Now, the intention of the interviewer is, you know, they are sick and tired of taking interviews. I mean, me, I have also taken a lot of interviews in my life. I pretty much now like CV de diya gaya mujhe, I'll just review it once so that I know who am I talking to. But I will basically induce the other person to mutter out something based on which I can have a conversation with you on. So the intention is, bhai, tu bata kuch to baat shuru kare. That's pretty much it. Bhai, aap hi bolein kuch, jisko I will pick one thread out of the sentences that you speak to me, and I will then basically start to ask you on that aspect that you have detailed out. So for example, let us say that you are a student of law and then you are applying for a associate's job in a law firm. So they pretty much know, you know, because you will be detailing out your marks, etc. So let us say that you are highly interested in your moot courts, or you were very, very active. Now, how do you basically explain that? You can actually start with this, that you, as you already know, my name is, you know, it is very odd to say, just go off with, oh, I was very active in my moot court society, in my law school. That is like, without, you haven't really broken the ice, you will basically flounder in your interview at this stage. As you already know, my name is such and such. I did my schooling from here. And mind you, don't make it too long, because this, all of this stuff is already on the CV, right? You want to give them one point on which you actually want to elaborate. For example, let us say that on your CV, it says that, again, moot court wala example lete hain. So, ji, I did my graduation from, let us say, any national law school or Delhi University, and I was very keen and active in the moot court society. Think about it. What will the examiner really ask you? Acha, what moot courts? Which moot court did you participate in, and how many? You need to have ready-made, ready-to-go answers for such questions. So, expect such cross-questioning, because, see, whatever you are going to say here, well, it is your moment to guide the conversation where you want it to go next, and it will go somewhere, right? And that you have to anticipate prior to the interview to make a good impression, because then you are coming pre-planned to what they will ask. For example, in the moot court example, then you need to have a ready-made top 2, 3 to 5 list of moot court competitions that you participated in, won, or just had a mighty good time, or what were you learning. So for example, what was the obvious next follow-up question? So what did you learn from that particular moot court that you have quoted to the interviewer? Think about it. So do this exercise one to two days prior to the interview. That is extremely crucial. Now, jo samne jo interviewer baitha hai, he's obviously not, you know, Vishnu Bhagwan, he's not a perfect human being, he doesn't know any and every aspect of each and every domain of knowledge. So don't be ultra scared, but also don't be trying to answer questions in a Miss India mode, that is being too idealistic. Wo samne wala yehi sochega, Mungeri Lal ke haseen sapne baith do, ki tum, you are just like, you know, not thinking practically. Because I'll tell you what, the work life, the work experience is, you know, it's far removed from academic realities. It was based on a lot of pragmatic stuff. And if you keep on theorizing there, the interviewer may just be pissed off. All right. So you can start off as you may already know, and then you elaborate on the thing that you want to tell them. So at the beginning level, at the fresher level, you may just not be able to do this, but later on, you always elaborate basically in the context of the job you are giving the interview for. So for example, let us say that I apply for a professorship at, let us say, Delhi University or at NLU. I will focus on my teaching experience here at TLOI and the other teaching experience that I have in teaching special children for their national open school examinations for the 10th and the 12th standard, right? Because that is relevant here. I may just not want to enter into details about my other businesses that I've attempted in life. I may just not want to get that because that is irrelevant for their purpose, right? So for example, let us say that you are applying for an associate job at a law firm right after your law school, because primarily this channel is geared towards that audience. You may just not want to focus how you were the cultural activities in charge back in your school days. That's irrelevant, right? So you were, it's good, it's listed out on your CV, but you just may not want to touch that subject because that is irrelevant for the interviewer. You are basically boring them to death, right? That is absolutely irrelevant stuff. Avoid that, because this is your chance to guide the conversation. And mind you, we don't get chances to guide life in the manner in which we want it to work, but this is your chance. So try to focus on getting the conversation to such a stage where it benefits you. So satyavadi harishchandra banne ki zarurat nahi hai ki main to ji itna hi zyada sach bol dunga ki aap mereko matlab naukri denge hi nahi, right? So smartly navigate this, but think about what the interviewer will ask you. In fact, want to do 2 days prior, not 2 days. I always make a blunder when I'm saying this. You ask yourself, what would you ask while looking at your CV? Think about it. For example, let us say that I have an economics honors on my degree, on my CV. I have a management honors on my CV. I have a LLB on my CV. I also have a couple of diplomas on my CV. So as an interviewer, if I were to see my own CV, I'll be like, yeah, apne ji economics and management honors bhi kari University of London se, uske baad aap school chala rahe hain, uske baad aap LLB kar rahe hain, you know, what exactly is going on here, right? So I need to have a standard set answer for this, that what exactly was I up to, because this is pretty much the obvious question that is shouting at me from my own CV. So some questions will shout at you from your own CV, and you need to have preset, predefined answers in which you can confidently answer, and you pretty much are dead set ki haan bhaiya, ye wo question hai jiske liye main exam mein padh kar gaya tha. Alright, so don't treat interviews as lightly, but not too much seriously as well. But please prepare it just like you would prepare for a question paper. And if that same question shows up that you are prepared for, aata na, anand aa jata hai na, swaad aa jata hai question paper, exam mein, right? Then the second thing is, tell us about your strengths and weaknesses. Well, bloody hell. This is a slightly dicey one, you know. Okay, let me give you a sample answer and then we'll discuss. Tell us about your strengths and weaknesses. Basically, ji, I work hard and I am willing to work hard on anything that I rather not know, and I'm willing to improve on that. That is my strength. So I'll acknowledge it that I don't know this area, and then work on it so that the company gets benefited. That's my strength. But what is your weakness? Let us say you pick out one weak area from your own arsenal. Let us say, so my weakness is in my mathematics ability, but I'm constantly working on it, and I've already invested in online courses, etc., so that the firm never takes a loss due to my inability to handle maths, and I take the aid of online calculators, etc., but I'm working on it. See, that is a good answer. The interviewer can't give you shit for that. So you need to have predefined answers such as this in your arsenal, in your, you know, weapons kitty when you're going for an interview. and that will really, really sort out life for you. I kid you not. So that this is basically the difference between you coming unprepared for an interview and despite you being the ideal candidate for the job being shown the door and the other guy taking in, right? Be prepared for the next question is my point. So whenever, let us say, you know, I talk about my degree from the University of London, if I, let us say that, they can ask, acha, how is it different from an Indian degree? Or let us say, what was the advantage? Why did you take that up? All of these questions can be asked, right, in an interview. And let us say that I am even looking at my own CV. I'll ask this. And the other guy goes like, This is pretty much the expression that interviewer ke antar atma is saying to you. So watch out for these. So these two questions, especially the first one, you need to give them a thread on which they can elaborate. And mind you, ye ek din ke sawal jawab nahi. This is just me giving an input, in fact, just trying to guide you as to how the interview process works. Because I find ki nobody tells all of these things. राइट या पढ़ाना वढ़ाना तो ठीक है रट्टे वट्टे मारा दे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन करा दिया आईपीसी करा दिया सीआरपीसी करा दी बट एक्चुअल में वो सब सही है वो तो यू नो यू व्हेनेवर यू आर सिटिंग फॉर एन एग्जाम दैट ऑलरेडी एनीवे गेट्स टेस्टेड बट दिस इज प्रीटी मच रियल लाइफ बियॉन्ड एकेडमिक्स एंड दिस प्रीटी मच यू नो आई फाइंड लाइक दैट्स अ ह्यूज शॉर्टेज ऑफ पीपल एक्चुअली गाइडिंग अदर्स हाउ टू टैकल ऑल ऑफ दिस सो थिंक अबाउट दिस इन फैक्ट इट विल टेक यू अ गुड लॉन्ग व्हाइल बिफोर यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट यू वांट टू आंसर. So start today, make a CV, make a resume for yourself and start and think as an interviewer, what will you ask yourself? And that ability will get refined as you take more and more interviews or rather as you give more and more interviews. So always taking an exam and I'm already giving an interview. When you're taking an interview, then basically you are interviewing somebody else, right? So that's pretty much the way to start. And we'll basically keep on elaborating on this discussion in our TLOI talk series as usual. And in fact, if you want general career advice related to law, this playlist is pretty much tailor-made for you. Explore it. I believe that you will get some very good points that can help you refine your life. All right. So stay safe and see you in the next one. See you on the other channel as well. Take care. Bye.